Number one, use the function f of x equals 4x and g of x equals x squared minus 1 to find the value of each expression. So for f of 1 plus g of 2, we will plug, this is a call to action to plug in 1 in for x for the f of x equals 4x and plug in 2 for x for g of x equals x squared minus 1. Let's go ahead and plug that in all together. That's 4 times what x was, which now is 1, plus then x squared minus 1 will now turn into 2 squared minus 1 for this g of x equals x squared minus 1. So 4 times 1, of course, is going to be, let's do order of operations. We'll do exponents first. 2 to the second is 4, and then 4 times 1 is 4 also, and we'll bring down the minus 1. From left to right, we're going to do addition and subtraction. 4 plus 4 is 8, minus 1 is 7. Looking at number 2, you've got g of 0, which means everywhere you see an x in the g of x function, you're going to substitute a 0. Same thing for f of 2. And so let's go ahead and do that first. G of 0 will turn into 0 squared minus 1. Then it says after that, minus 3 times what is f of 2? That's going to be times 4 times 2, because 2 gets replaced with x, or x gets replaced with 2 for 4x. Let's go ahead and go with order of operations. 0 squared is 0 times 0, which is 0. And if we subtract that from 1, that will pretty much just disappear. But I do need to take care of multiplication before I do addition subtraction. So from left to right here, that's going to be negative 3 times 4, which is a negative 12 times 2. I still take care of multiplication before addition and subtraction. So negative 12 times 2 will give me a negative 24. And then from there, a negative 1 minus 24 is a negative 25 for my answer. Number 3, if you see a function within a function, then you need to handle the function inside first. So we will take care of g of negative 1 first, and then we'll take we'll place that number within the function of x. So let's do g of negative 1 first. That's going to be replacing x with a negative 1 to the second minus 1. So negative 1 squared is positive 1. Minus 1 turns out to be 0. We will take the g of negative 1, the result from that, and we will now substitute that in for f of x. Since f of x is 4 times x, we now will write that as 4 times x, which is 0. So 4 times 0 is now 0. Again, a reminder, take care of the function inside first, and then substitute that number as a result into your other function. All right, number 4, the function m of x equals 60x represents the number of miles m of x you travel for x hours that you drive. How many miles will you drive in 5 hours? So they give us the independent variable hours, and we will substitute that into our function. We'll say m of 5, because the x, the hours, is 5, equals 60 times 5. And of course, 60 times 5 is 300 miles in that 5 hours. All right, number 5. The function h of x equals 2.5x plus 20 represents your height in inches, h of x, for x years that you have been alive. How many inches tall will you be when you are 12 years old? So in the event that your height, your growth is linear, which would be interesting, we could substitute in place of x the 12 years. So we are going to the independent variable years. That's going to go in place of x. So H of 12 equals 2.5 times 12 plus 20. And then 2.5 times 12 is going to be 30 plus 20. Therefore, you would have 50 inches in 12 years. Number six, the domain of f of x equals 4x plus 1 is 1, 2, 3, 4, and what is the range? So they've given us a list of x's because domain is x. So one at a time, we'll substitute that in. F of 1, which is our first x, equals 4 times 1 plus 1. 4 times 1 is 4 plus 1 is 5. First member of the range, the range is 5. So next, f of the next member of the domain, which is 2, that'll be 4 times 2 plus 1. 4 times x plus 1, 4 times 2 plus 1. 4 times 2 is 8 plus 1 is 9. Second member in our range. F of 3, that's going to be 4 times 3 plus 1. 4 times 3 is 12 plus 1 is 13. F of 4, that's going to equal. Everywhere we see an x, we will. This is a call to action to substitute 4. Everywhere we see an x, so it'll be 4 times 4 plus 1. 4 times 4 is 16 plus 1 is 17. So in set notation, we will write in the brackets 5, 9, 13, and 17 for our range. Number 7, the range of f of x equals negative 5x is negative 5, 0, 10, 15. What is the domain? So this time they give us we will have the y values. And you're going to substitute in place of f of x because f of x and y are interchangeable. Y is a function of x. So we get to plug these in for y one at a time. So here we go. In place of f of x, we'll put negative 5 equals negative 5x. And we will solve for x. So we'll divide both sides by negative 5. We divide by itself. And x equals negative 5 divided by negative 5 is 1. First member of our domain is 1. Next, let's try in place of f of x, we're going to put 0. So it'll be 0 equals negative 5x. Divide both sides by negative 5. 0 divided by negative 5 is 0. So x equals 0, the second member of our domain. Next, we're going to substitute 10. So it'll be 10 in place of all of f of x. And that's going to be 10 equals negative 5x. Divide by itself to isolate x, and that's going to give us x equals 10 divided by negative 5, positive divided by negative is negative, 10 divided by 5 is 2, third member of the domain is negative 2. And lastly, we're going to substitute in place of f of x, we'll put 15. So 15 equals a negative 5x, divide by itself, divide both sides by negative 5. 15 divided by negative 5 is a negative 3. So now as we write these are all the X's that we need for our domain. And understand that this is membership. It is not, we're going to write it in order, numerical order. And it is okay that it is not in the order that we got our responses, our answers. This is just the members of our domain, so we are okay to write it in numerical order. Number 8, Beth wants to earn $500 to purchase a new television. She earns $8 an hour at her job. The function B of H equals 8H represents the amount of money Beth earns in dollars. B of H for each hour H that she works. What domain and range are reasonable for the function? Let's start with the domain in set notation. And the lowest number of hours that she would work would probably be 0 hours. You don't really want to go negative. She could work absolutely no hours. And we'll assume that she's going to work a full 40-hour work week. We'll put H in the middle, and we'll put the inequality signs on either side. So H is greater than or equal to 0, but less than or equal to 40 hours, which is definitely reasonable. So now let's go to the range. We need the resulting dollars earned in this instance. So we will plug those into B of H equals 8H. So 8, if we plugged 0 in for H, B of 0, that's 8 times 0. That will give us $0. She works 0 hours. she will earn $0. And the higher extreme, 40 times the, if we did B of 40, that would be 8 times 40, which is 320 earnings. And of course, we'll put the B of H in the middle for the B of H for her dollars. All right, moving on. Number 9, you want to make pillows for your bed. You have 5 yards of fabric and need 0.6 yards of fabric for each pillow. The function M of P equals 0.6P represents the amount of material in yards M of P to make P pillows. What domain and range are reasonable for the function? So let's start with the domain. And what did P represent? That's going to be pillows. So the least amount of pillows would probably be 0. And then this could vary, but we'll say that the maximum would be 6. And in the middle, we are going to put P. Then we need 2 inequality signs. So we will say that you will make for the number of pillows would be greater than or equal to 0, but less than or equal to 6. Let's plug that in and get our range. So the range, if you do plug 0 in for M of 0, you would multiply 0.6 times 0. You would need 0 yards of fabric. The upper extreme, if we were to plug 6 into the M of P, that would be M of 6, and you would multiply 0.6 times 6, which is 3.6 yards of fabric in set notation. In the middle, we will write M of P and we will make sure and have 2 inequality signs facing the same direction. So M of P will be greater than or equal to 0, but less than or equal to 3.6 for your range. Hope this helps. Have a great day.